after so long to have both of the first two children, you know, we had, I'll say, some medical scares with Denny that really threw us for a loop.
Jilly!
Mandy and Brian English have been married 15 years, and since day one, they always dreamed of having a large family.
I have horrible pregnancies with Joy. I had several conditions.
But having that large family came with numerous complications, a lost pregnancy and two miscarriages. Failures and heartbreak consumed Mandy and Brian, but they were determined.
God gave me some sort of very strong will to continue to have children.
Eventually, the Englishes welcomed a baby girl, Joy. A son, Denny, would soon follow. But years had been lost trying for children, so they froze eggs and had planned on eventually using a surrogate to carry a future baby. In the meantime, their desire for more children led them in a different direction they were not expecting, adoption. Now enter their Amazing Grace.
Hi.
Adoption was more than we ever thought it could be, and Grace saved us.
Mandy and Brian's family was growing, and as they were about to enter their next phase to add to their family, they received the devastating news that their eggs and viable embryos were destroyed back in March, along with thousands of others, during a catastrophic failure in a storage tank at University Hospital's fertility clinic. Mandy and Brian's hopes of having another biological child gone.
When you guys found out the news of what had happened at UH, what was going through your mind?
How could you make that decision with people's futures?
No, you're doing it!
For the English family and the hundreds of other families affected, they may never have the answers. When the time is right, Amanda and Brian will begin the adoption process again and hope to inspire others.
It won't be for everyone, and that's okay. I hope that they find a way to heal as well. But for those of us that cannot go through the procedure again, that lost ovaries due to cancer, that are older now, that the experience was very tragic, very hard, affected their life, their family. I hope that they'll consider.
Another part of the English's healing, a mural that they are working on to help tell the stories of every single person touched by the University Hospital's tragedy, and to never forget those babies who would have been.
So we're surrounded by the snowflakes that sort of go up into the sky, turn into stars, that they're always there.
Why snowflakes? Well, oftentimes frozen embryos are lovingly referred to as snowflake babies. The Englishes are asking families to email them and share their story so they can be added to this mural. It's called Because of You, and each story is unique and equally powerful.
I will fight to make sure that this never happens again. Because of you, I will make sure that there are controls in place at these institutions that could have prevented this. Gracie, go night-night.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Brian and Mandy are so very thankful for each of their children because in the end, it's not how they came together. Everyone was brought together, they know, by so much love.
Anyone considering adoption, and I hope some of the women that lost in this tragedy will consider it. We can make something good out of this, and we can't change it. They're gone, you know? But we can move forward in ways. And I'm not saying that all these women have to be ready to move forward. Everybody grieves on their own timeline. I hope that they talk about what could make them heal.
Stephanie Schaefer, Fox 8 News, Cleveland.